Thank you, Roger, for that. Well, 4 days after a teenager was killed by a hit-and-run driver in Oxford County, and still no one is claiming responsibility.
Paris police are hopeful the two persons of interest will shed some light on the case. WMTW News 8's Jim Keithley is live in Paris with an update after speaking to Xavier Fuentes' family. Jim?
Well, Steve, as police continue to hunt down that hit-and-run driver, I again spoke today with Javier's family members who say he was really so excited to return on Monday to the Lovett Area High School in Turner. That's where he grew up. Now, for the last semester, his mother and stepmother had moved to the Bethel area, and he attended the Telstar High School. But again, his grandmother said he was just so excited to stay with her during the week and return to the Bethel area with his mother on the weekends. But he really wanted to get back to the high school where he loved so much. Tonight, new pictures of a happy teenage boy. Javier Fuentes, always wearing his earbuds, listening to music, said his grandmother. His sudden death a shock, even more upsetting to know that the person who hit him while he walked along Route 117 in South Paris Saturday night is still eluding police. Detectives say the tips are slowing down, but they have made some headway. A tipster gave them a couple of names. Now they're trying to figure out if they know anything about the accident.
We are focusing our efforts on two individuals. Based on the tipsters that have called in. And it's just an ongoing investigation right now until we can either clear them or focus in on one person.
Police are also checking with auto body repair shops to see if anyone has brought in a large size vehicle with front end damage. The medical examiner is releasing the body to the family for burial. Cause of death was multiple blunt force injuries. The manner of death is still being investigated.